You may be thinking, Katie, why do you look different in the thumbnail? Because this is my second time filming this sucker. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Katie, and if you're new, hi, I make book style videos, and if you're not new, welcome back. Today's video will be talking about my first 5-star read of the year. Mind you, this is my second time filming this. My first time, the first take I did of this was gold, okay? I was so proud of that stupid video, and then I go to edit it and it had no sound. For those of you who make videos, can you feel my pain? This is disgusting. I am disgusted. I do not know if my energy is going to be as up as it was in the first video. I'm going to try. That's my rant. I am sorry. Okay, so like I said, if you enjoy these type of videos, reviews, me talking about the books I read, be sure to give me a thumbs up. If you're new, hit the subscribe button if you want to see more. All my social media is linked down below, as always. And without further ado, let's talk about this book again. Spoiler alert! There will be spoilers in this video because I cannot talk about this book without giving spoilers. I mean, I could, but I don't wanna. So if you haven't read the book yet and you want to leave, I completely understand. If you have read it and you want to continue, that's cool too. But just be forewarned, there are spoilers in this video. Okay, so I read one 5-star book last year, and that was Lovely War by Julie Barry. It was a different genre for me. I had never read the genre. I didn't think I would like the YA historical fiction romance, but I did. I enjoyed it. It was my favorite book until I read this one. This book is now my all-time favorite. It is becoming my favorite series. This is my favorite book out of the series, no doubt. I haven't even finished the series. I know it's going to be this book. I am reading book 3 right now. I'm about halfway done, and it does not compare to this at all. So let's just give a little backstory. We're going to put the hair down, see if that was a little better. Okay, maybe I can get some of my mojo back from the first time I filmed this. My brain will remember what I wrote. What I said, because I didn't write any notes down. I was just going off the wall about this book because I love it so much, but then there was no sound. Oh my god. Okay. Anyway, so I read A Court of Thorns and Roses. I enjoyed it. I gave it like a 4.5 stars, I think. I didn't give it a 5, but I enjoyed it because I love Beauty and the Beast. We all know this by now, hopefully. But again, I knew going in that Endgame was Fae Rhea and Rhysand, and I know her name's not Fae Rhea, but it's my nickname, okay? So there's Tam Tam the Ferryman, there's Rhysand, and there's Fae Rhea. So when you hear those names, just know that I mean Tamlin, Feyre, and Rhysand. Rhysand doesn't have a nickname because he's perfect. He doesn't need a nickname, okay? So I knew going in that their endgame, I just didn't know how it was gonna come to be. So a little backstory into the first book to get you caught up. At the end of the first book, Feyre has broken the curse and, I'm sorry, I just sneezed like twice and I can't breathe. Okay, so she broke the curse, but in doing so, she ended up dying. So all the 7 High Lords came together, put a little bit of them into her. That's kinky. Anyway, and brought her back to life. So the book ends with her going back to the Supreme Court with Tamlin, but keeping in mind that she will have to she has a deal with Rhysand, so that will happen in the second book. So that's how the first book ends. She goes home, everything's fine. Okay, the second book starts a couple months later. They're engaged, I think. I'm pretty sure they're engaged. Tam Tam, the ferryman, and her. She's got PTSD issues so bad. Like, it's bad. she's having these vivid dreams of Under the Mountain, to the point where it's making her like puke her guts out every night, and Tam Tam the ferryman apparently can't hear her. So we don't like Tamlin here. We're not a stan. So if you are, Anyway, so you're just telling me that this high lord of the Supreme Court that has fey hearing can hear his fiancée in the next room puking her guts out every night. Okay. Okay. Anyway, so he just lays there, acts like he's asleep. He can hear it, and okay. This girl is breaking. Like, she is physically breaking, mentally breaking, spiritually breaking, every way possible, she is breaking. Tamlin is very protective of her, so he is very, in a toxic way. Like, she can't do anything for herself. She's always stuck in the house, doesn't want her helping, doing anything. But mind you, all the while, she has to start her deal with Rhysand, going to his house every month, for a week. So that's all, like, I was interested in. Like, I just wanted to get to the Rhys parts. So, like, I will have to, like, do, like, a second reread of this, because I'm sure there's things that I would catch, but I was so just, like, flying through this book to get to the Rhys parts that it was just, like, I wasn't fully mentally taking everything in, if that makes any sense. So we got Tam Tam, and he's just like, you stay, you're mine. Goop, like, gorilla, just like taking control, being a very just terrible person. And all the while, they're also like getting their wedding ready. So, like, Tam Tam brings in this high priestess. I don't know her name. Ianthe? Ianthe? Ianth? I don't care. I don't like her. So she comes in, she's like, oh my god, the most beautiful wedding ever. That's just how I picture her voice being. It's okay. But, like, she's Feyre is breaking. Like, I say Feyre because she's now a fairy. If you did not know, it's Feyre. It's fine. But, like, she is just breaking. And she is now going to Velaris, or Velaris. I don't know how you say it. Again, I don't care. I say it in my head, so it just kind of works out that way. But she's going there, and she's with Rhys, and Rhys is seeing, like, she's just sickly looking. Like, she's lost so much weight. She's just, I mean, he still thinks she's beautiful, but that's, no, we're not there yet. But she's just broken down, and it's a very bad relationship that she's in, but she's traumatized. Tamlin's traumatized. They just kind of, like, traumatized people go towards each other sometimes. It's just how it is. So while she's there, she meets Rhys's inner circle. So we meet some new characters in this book. We love the inner circle. We meet Mor. We meet, that's her name. We don't meet Mor. We meet Morrigan, who is Mor. And then we meet Cassian and Azriel and Amarin, the inner circle. Talk more about them later. Just know the inner circle is a wonderful group of people, and we should all be friends with them. But while she's there, she's also learning to read because she can't read. And Rhys is like, you're gonna learn to read. So he's teaching her to read, and he's like, the words that he's teaching her to read, these sentences are like, Rhys is the greatest lover of all time. And I'm probably not the only one thinking that. It's probably true. Tis probably true. Anyway, she's going back and forth. I don't remember how many months it is between her, what, like, her going to Rhys and her wedding. So it's a few months maybe, but her wedding comes, she's freaking out. Has every right to freak out, okay? She's like, in her head, she's like, please someone help me. Like, cause, and Rhys is all the while, like, feeling her, cause, you know, they got that bond, they got that bond. He's feeling her feels, and he's just waiting. He's just waiting for the word to come get her. So once she's like, someone help me, he's like, boom, I'm here. I'm here. Has anyone seen that TikTok going around where it's like Rhysand getting ready to go get Feyre from the wedding? Like, I don't know if I can find it, but if I do, like, I'll put it in here, or I'll link it down below, because that guy, I don't know who he is, but, like, yes, please.
Desperado.
Anyway, so he comes, and I can't quite remember exactly what happens. I know they don't get married, but I also know he doesn't take her. Like, I don't remember. Or does he take her? See, like, I flew through this book, so I'm like, on, like, the little details. But either way, she comes back to Tamlin a week later. I'm pretty sure he takes her for the week. And they start the week. I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong. Anyway, she comes back to Tamlin. Tamlin's like, well, you're never leaving this house again. Basically, she wants to go help because there's something at the border that's starting to happen. And he's going to go see and patrol it. And she wants to go with him. And he's like, no, you're staying here. You're staying here. In fact, you're staying here. I'm locking you in the house. So that breaks the poor girl. She has a panic attack. She's done. There's wind blowing. There's fire going. Because all the while, no one knows that she's developing these powers from each of the high courts. High lords in the courts. So she's got fire. She's got wind. She's all these things. And Tamlin leaves because that's what he does best. And then Reese and Moore comes, but of course Reese can't go in because it'll break some sort of like law they have, but Moore can. So Moore goes in, picks her up, winnows her away. And mind you, they do a lot of winnowing. So like, if you ever want to do like a drink this every time you see this book or see this word, like don't do a drinking game with the word winnow. You'll be dead. You'll be dead. There's a lot of winnowing in that book. A lot of winnowing in the third book. It's just a lot of winnowing going on. Okay. So they take her, bring her to Valaris. I don't know. It's okay. Like I said, I'm the only one speaking it in my head. And she is now there at his townhouse. And he says, you can live here. You can live anywhere in the city. Like, I'm not going to force you to live, you know, anything like that. And that, my dear friends, is where the book starts getting amazing. Okay, a lot of stuff happens in this book, and I'm gonna skip over it all until we get to the cabin scene. So I just skipped about 100 and so many pages. I'm not even like, wait, I'm pretty sure it's like 200 some pages I just skipped. It is, like I said, I knew Bay Ray and Rhysand were endgame. So I knew, and I also know that this book is very smutty. I was here for the smut. Excuse me, ma'am. I did not get to that smut until about 400 and some pages in. Why? Like, I understood we had to develop her character. Okay, we get that. She was broken. She needed to find herself again. We get that. I was just here for the fairy smut. And you know what? After I read these books, I'm still going to be here for the fairy smut. If I take anything away from the series is the fact I like fairy smut. So if you have recommendations of fairy smut books, please leave them down below because I'm here for it. Anyway, we are now in the city of Valaris. No, we're not. We're skipping all that because skip's the good part. The cabin scene. I'm skipping the tavern scene. I'm skipping this. Am I skipping the city? The Court of Nightmares scene? Was that after? I'm pretty sure that's after. Yeah, because why would he? Yeah. Okay, we're not there yet. Don't mind me. Don't mind this hot mess express of a video. Like I said, I didn't write notes. I'm just going off what I remember. So, we're at the cabin scene. It's the pivotal scene. Y'all know what it is. It's the time for Reese to tell her everything. Everything under the mountain, Amarantha, the bond. Because she now knows that she's his mate, but like she's just like, I don't know. And I'm like, girl, why? He's gorgeous. But like, I know Reese is problematic too. Like, don't get me wrong, I understand that, but I'm willing to cancel that out because I love him and he's a fictional character, so I can do that. And I hate Tam Tam, so we're going with Reese. So the cabin scene, he is telling her everything. Like, he started dreaming about her before he met her. Like, he was dreaming through her eyes. That's how deep their bond goes. Okay, he was sending her visions of what to paint before they met. So that's why she painted like the night sky. That's why she felt at home at the night court. It's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing. And then he's like, I was gonna let you marry him if that's what it was for you to be happy. Like, I was going to sacrifice my happiness. And we love someone who's going to sacrifice their happiness for someone else. So yes, stuff happens. He explains. They talk. They do more than talk. They mate. It was a beautiful scene. It was a beautiful couple scenes, actually. And little did I know before reading this book that a fairy's wingspan tells you more than just their wings and their wingspan. So Rhysand's very blessed. Anyway, so we go from that to more stuff happens. We get to the city of Hune City. We're getting to the end of the book now, because there's a whole second plot to this book right here, and stuff's happening, and they need to get this book of breathings. Half of a book, the day court, summer court had, second half of the book, Court of Nightmares had, I think. They're gonna bring the books together, they're gonna take it to the Hune City because King Highburn is on a tantrum, okay? And he just wants to destroy the wall to go to the mortals and all this and all, okay? You're caught up, good. Okay, so we're going, we're at Hune City. And they go and take the book to the cauldron so they can stop whatever he's doing. Oh, but wait, no. He knew they were coming. He catches them. He takes them to his throne room, which looks an awful lot like Amarantha's throne room under the mountain. So that's bringing back like some traumatizing thoughts for, I'm sure, Rhysand as well as Fay Wray. And they get to the throne room and freaking lo and behold, guess who's there? Guess who is there? That's right, freaking Tam Tam. Tam Tam's there because he was working in cahoots with, okay, because I did not tell you, but during the book, she writes to Tamlin and is like, I'm fine. I'm staying here though, so peace out. It was nice knowing you. And Tam Tam's very, my girl, bye, okay? So like, he sees Feyre and he's like, come Feyre. And I'm like, excuse me, sir, get your hand away because I'm not coming. Just a thing, like, no. But, so he was working with the king, and the king was like, I will bring you Feyre in exchange for, I don't even know what he's in exchange for. I can't remember. Was it bringing Feyre's sisters to the place? Because that's what he does. They got Feyre's sisters, Elaine and Nesta, who were just right now the most boringest characters in the world to me. Like, I can't empathize with them. Like, right now, Nesta in the book I'm reading, she's a pain. I don't know if the book, next book that comes out in February, is going to explain what she is. Because right now, I don't know what she is. I didn't finish the third book yet, so maybe it tells me. Maybe the fourth novella does. I don't know. But, like, if it does, don't let me know, because I will read. But right now, I just don't like her. I don't care. And Elaine's just, poor girl, she's like, just, she just wants to go get married. She was supposed to get married. And can you imagine living like that? Like, back then it was like, if you don't get married, it's like, oh, woe is me. I have to get married. That's all I'm good for. Like, I'm 31. So I would have been a spinster in those days. But here I am, 31, living my best life, okay? Because she don't need a man to be happy. I could not have lived back then. I'm sorry. Rant over. I can't. Bugs me. Anyway. So he brings the sisters, the stupid king is going to throw the sisters into the cauldron. He throws them in. Right before he throws them in, though, Lucien looks at Elaine. Elaine looks at Lucien, and Lucien's like, mate. So that's a thing. They're a thing. They're not a thing, actually, in this book right now that I'm reading. She's like, I'm supposed to be married today. I'm supposed to be married today. I'm supposed to be married today. Literally, that's all the girl says. That's all the girl says. I understand it's a traumatizing thing, but like, chill. They're not my favorite. So they get thrown in and they come out and they're fairies. So there's that. They're fairies, and Nesta is something completely weird. I don't know what she is. Don't know what she did. Don't know where she went, what she did, what she brought back. Don't know. But anyway, so Fay Wray knows she's not getting out of this alive. She knows she's not. They're not getting out of this. So she pretends to break the bond. But wait, you can't. Because at the end of the book, we get Rhysand's point of view, and we learn that the night before all this happening with the cauldron, they went and got married. Which, like, what? Yeah, they're mated, they're bonded, they proclaimed their love, they're mated. You can't break the bond. It's too deep, okay? So she fakes it, as some girls have to. She fakes it, breaks the bond. Tamlin thinks it's broke, because him and the king are thinking that, like, Rhys put a spell on her to make her, like, love him and all this stuff. Uh-uh. No, Tam-Tam. You need the freaking spell. Because you're a... Blech. Rhys needs no spell, okay? Because look at him. Look at him. He's beautiful. I'm just a fangirl of Rhys, okay? So she fakes it. She's like, Tam-Tam, take me home. So Tam-Tam takes her home. And during these last 50 pages of this book, my mind was, okay, I was feeling feelings I didn't know existed. I was hurt. I was surprised. I was angry. I was happy. And then I was so angry because she left, but I did not know that they already made it. And well, I knew they made it, but they bonded. They had the ceremony. It was good. And like, they leave, they take the sisters back to Valaris, and Amarin's like, what the frick did you do, boy? Why'd you let her go? Like, what happened? And he's like, it's fine. She wanted to. But all the while, in our head, we're like, I'm reading in his head. And it's like, what they don't know is that we already bonded. We bonded. Where she's like the high lady of the night court. It's all good in the hood. So the book ends with Fay Wray going back to the spring court. And we're getting her point of view. And she's like, you know what, Tam-Tam? I'm taking down this court from the inside. From the inside. Yes. Like, And that's the book. That's the book. In a nutshell. There's plenty of stuff I missed. Like, you know, she learns to train and stuff. And it's a great time. But that doesn't matter. Okay, this book is not plot heavy. It's character driven. So I'm okay with that. But that is the book in a nutshell. It's my second time filming this. I think the first one was better, but it's okay. But if you enjoyed this video and you're still here, be sure to put this emoji in the comments down below, because this emoji is only fitting for this book, of course. But if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give me a thumbs up. And if you're new and want to see more of my face, you can always watch my videos and subscribe to my channel. I would be very happy if you subscribe to my channel. But yeah, all my social media is linked down below as always. But let me know in the comments. Did you like this book as much as I did if you read it? And if you didn't like this book as much as I did, why? Please let me know either way. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye, guys. Are you all still here? Why are you all still here? I said goodbye. Are you waiting for me to do something funny? Like I normally do? Well, I can't, because I can't think of anything. So, but I will tell you what to do. You're going to go read the book, or go read a book. This is me telling you, go finish that book you need to finish right now. That's been sitting on your shelf. Go.